I stepped into Major Hitchin's office and was immediately told that they had gathered more intel on the location of another possible location for the communication codes. I learned a long time ago that it was pointless to ask questions, even if I was the Major's prized pawn in this never-ending game of chess. I'm a soldier with a job to do, and I'll be damned if I'm going to fail. The codes are apparently in a submarine base on the Truk Islands. The only catch is that once I get in the vicinity of the base, I have to be a ghost. The enemy can't know that I was ever there. If a single alarm is raised, the codes will be changed and thousands of my brethren may die as a result. Not on my watch.
Truk Lagoon, a part of the Caroline Island Group, served as a Japanese naval base for a large part of the Pacific War. From here, the Japanese launched their fleet in crucial operations, including the Solomon Islands and New Guinea campaign. After the American capture of the Marshall Islands, they would launch an attack against the Japanese fleet that would result in some of the most substantial naval losses in the history of warfare.
I don't need to tell you how important this is. Those communication codes could save hundreds of our soldiers. Thousands, maybe. Absolute discretion is what we need. What is required. Soldiers are all over the island. But once you get in range of the submarine base, discretion must be your watchword. If you alert anyone, any soldier in that sub-base, the mission fails. If you need to confront the enemy, make sure you do it silently.
Thank you.
The battle that came after my mission culminated in one of the most important naval battles of war. 12 Japanese warships, 32 merchant ships, and 249 aircraft were destroyed. That was fine and dandy. Hopefully it will bring us that much closer to a complete victory. For me, the knowledge of the American lives saved gave me some of the most peaceful sleep I've had in years.